at the Suni Williams School, named for her, thunderous applause during morning announcements announcing her safe return. But now Suni has all of the homework to do. She has to share a lot of medical data with NASA. So we did speak with a U.S. Air Force colonel and someone retired from NASA who's still getting annual physicals and still in awe of these missions.
I realized that it was hard to breathe and hard to unclench my stomach until we saw the first two parachutes.
Katie Coleman retired from NASA 7 years ago, but still had all the feelings Tuesday at 5:57 p.m. The Boeing Starliner's problems turned an eight-day mission into 9 months for Needham native Suni Williams and Butch Wilmore. They are still hard at work, with NASA now measuring everything, even their bone density.
We lose bone about 10 times faster than someone with osteoporosis. And so being part of a study to help understand how osteoporosis works is something very meaningful.
Coleman's book, Sharing Space, An Astronaut's Guide to Mission Wonder and Making Change, came out last summer. And today she reminds us how the brain and middle ear deal with gravity. She was last in space in 2011.
You can take your pinky finger and give yourself a little push, and it'll send you across the whole space station.
A return to gravity on Earth can cause nausea and fainting.
I've flown a lot with Butch, and Suni and I have been friends.
A post-mission stay in Houston is to better protect them.
Our skin actually up there gets thinner and more sensitive. And so in your skin, you can think of it in lots of different ways, but ultimately it is your barrier for disease.
For these astronauts, sometimes the blood vessels don't always restrict. They return to Earth with a smaller heart. So all of these medical data points have to be documented right away, and they will be followed for weeks, months, and possibly years. Live in Needham, Rondella Richardson, WCVB News Center 5.